As the magma cooled further, its lateral mass of rock grew larger, as if she were coming together to form a hard rocky crust, floating on the mantle below. The crust of the earth continues to float on this mantle today. Meanwhile, the crust of the earth could squeeze into a super hot, dense core of solid iron and nickel. But the story doesn't end here. This outside crust of the planet is being constantly recycled through plate tectonics, forming the active planet we live on. The Earth has four layers, defined by the stuff they're made from: the brittle crust, the thick oozy mantle, the liquid metal outer core, and the solid metal inner core. The Earth's temperature increases toward the center of the planet. This heat is partly left over from Earth's formation, but heat is also being produced inside the Earth due to the decay or breakdown of radioactive elements found there. Unstable radioactive elements naturally emit more heat as they break down into more stable forms. This breakdown produces energy in the form of heat, which escapes the inner Earth in two ways: through conduction, which is a direct transfer of heat from one object to another, like from a stove burner to the bottom and sides of a pot; or convection, which is how heat is transferred by currents of fluid, with hotter currents rising and cooler currents sinking. Convection currents inside the Earth make the Earth's mantle flow like boiling water in a pot. The deepest mantle is heated by energy from radioactive decay and rises toward the surface. As it reaches the surface, it spreads out, and then it cools and sinks back into the Earth. It's this constant convection motion, the continuous heating and cooling of the mantle, which drives plate tectonics, thereby changing the face of the planet. The rising mantle reaches the surface, spreading plates apart. New ocean ridges form. Here, hot mantle erupts as underwater volcanoes, then quickly cools, forming new crust. Along the edges of old ocean basins are mountain belts, formed with old, cold oceanic plates, dive back into the mantle beneath the continent. As they sink, they melt and are recycled. The oldest rocks on the planet were part of the earliest crust formed and are up to 4 billion years old, almost as old as the Earth itself. They're represented by the purple and blue on this map, and as you can see, are found in the centers of the continents. As we move away from the central cores of the continents, we find increasingly younger rocks, green and yellow, until we get to the youngest continental rocks of all, red, found in mountain belts skirting the oceans, where volcanic activity builds new continental crust today. Find these red zones on the map, and you've identified where tectonic plate boundaries are. These are the active zones of the Earth. Scientists can identify the age of the continents by determining the age of the rocks found in these places. Flip-flop to look at the age of the crust beneath the oceans. Overall, it's quite a bit younger, only 200 million years old at its oldest, the blue, which is 20 times younger than the oldest continental rocks we just saw. That tells us there's more Earth recycling going on here. The red represents the mid-ocean ridges where new oceanic crust is being formed. The crust becomes older and older as it is slowly pushed away from the ridge. By studying the ages of these ocean floor rocks, scientists can reconstruct how plates have moved over time. The continents that we recognize today were once in very different places. Michigan, on the North American continent, was near the equator and covered by a warm, shallow sea. Over millions of years, the North American continent drifted northward and collided with other continents, forming the supercontinent, Pangaea. During the Mesozoic era, the age of the dinosaurs, tectonic plates carrying the continents separated, causing Pangaea to break apart and the continents to disperse again, with ocean basins forming between them. This dispersal has continued throughout the Cenozoic era and into today, where continents are still slowly drifting apart as seafloors spread. Based on what we know from plate tectonics, we can predict that in the future, Africa will continue to collide with Eurasia, Antarctica will stop from space, and the Americas will collide with Africa once again, forming another supercontinent. There are three major types of tectonic plate boundaries, or ways that plates interact with each other. When plates slip past each other in a horizontal motion, offsetting geologic features like this ocean ridge,